Hello students, welcome to lecture number 12. Topic for today's session is process characteristics in operations, volume, variety and flow. I Dr. Rohan Prabhakar Devale welcome you all. This is online lecture series. The subject is operations and supply chain management, lecture number 12. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Learning objectives for today's sessions are to know the basic concepts of operations process and to understand the basic concept of operation process. We will start with operation process. Operation is a process designed to convert various inputs into a valuable product or service that is output through a transformation process. These processes are termed as operations processes. Designing an operation process is crucial for any firm, as it may provide competitive advantage to that firm. Various types of raw materials, information, ideas, capital, manpower, machineries, etc. become the input in a manufacturing process to result in desired output. That desired output can be a product or service. Creativeness or improvement in the operation process designs add value and also helps companies to perform better. A well-designed operation process may have various benefits. Now we will see the benefits to a particular firm. So benefits from designing an operation processes to a particular firm. These benefits are low cost of manufacturing, reduction in the lead time for the customers, efficiency in operations, reduction in process time, and high quality products to deliver high value for the customers. Now we will understand process characteristics in operations. Production is the process of conversion of raw materials into finished goods. The conversion process is known as operations process. There are many ways and types of these processes depending on main three characteristics, namely volume, variety and flow. These characteristics having significant influence on the processes. Process characteristics in operations, just now we have seen, can be broadly categorized as: first characteristics is volume, second characteristics is variety, and third characteristics is flow. So volume, variety and flow. Now we will see in detail one by one. We will start with volume. Volume describes the amount of quantity produced by a particular production unit. The volume can be average output of the company in a particular time. That is 200 quantity of output in a week or 10,000 quantity of output in a particular year. The companies can be classified depending on the volume, that is large volume, mid volume or low volume categories. Next characteristics is variety. Variety describes the amount of various items, that is variety of items produced by any company. Third characteristics is flow. Flow describes every company's transformation process from raw materials to finished goods. Flow indicates company's manufacturing process with its nature and intensity to produce outputs. Now we will try to understand relationship between volume and variety. Carefully observe this figure. At the left hand side, we can see high volume products. So naturally, volume is high, thus variety is typically low. This is the example of mass production. So example of automobile sector, that is two wheelers and four wheelers, where volume is typically very high, but the variety is very low. In between, there are examples of pharmaceutical sector where mid volume and mid variety products are there. So pharmaceutical companies are the example where the volume is medium and variety is also medium. At the right hand side, we can see large variety, but here typically volume is very low. We can take example of any project execution. In that particular project, variety is high, but the volume is typically low. That is only one or two products. So this is the relationship between volume and variety. Now we will try to understand types of processes and operation system. Operations processes broadly classified into two categories. One is continuous flow system and another is intermittent flow system. Continuous flow system can be further categorized into assembly lines, continuous flow, and mass production. Just now I said that operation processes can be broadly classified into two categories. One is continuous flow system and another is intermittent flow system. This intermittent flow system can be further categorized into batch production, job shop production, and project. So these are types of processes and operation system. In my coming lecture, in detail, we will understand continuous flow system, intermittent flow system, and the categories. This is the book of Operations and Supply Chain Management of Simba Publication, written by myself. In my next video, we'll try to understand continuous flow system. Learning outcomes from today's lecture, we have understood the basic concepts of operation processes, and we have seen the characteristics of operation process, that is volume, variety, and flow. Don't forget to like, share, comment, subscribe, and turn on the bell icon for further notifications. Thanks from Dr. Rohan Prabhakar Dahivale. These are some references I have used to prepare this video. Thank you.